Let's do this. Okay, so what would you do? I need your help. We need your help. We have been hard at work to create the Bucket List cartoon, and we received an offer from a major network to buy our story and partner with us to develop our cartoon. But what would you do? Do we let the big network buy our story, trust them creatively, and see what they can do with it? Or do we take it upon ourselves, create our own story independently? But I would then lose a lot of final say over the creative, like, final product.
I know,
but
you get in with one of these, like, big companies, and it gets in front of so many more eyes as well, you know?
Potentially. It's a big decision, because it's a big deal, and it's been stressing me out all week, because after 3 long months of negotiations, the network said, you need to decide by Friday. You're either going to sign this deal or not. And today is Saturday morning, and we made our decision. Okay, let me explain what happened.
In a quarter mile, turn right onto Colorado Avenue.
So? Are you nervous?
No.
How are you not nervous?
Should I be nervous?
Yeah, you should be nervous. Oh, this is our first meeting.
Together?
I'm nervous.
You're so professional.
As I've explained before, I'm a rookie, meaning I have done nothing of the sort like this before. And the good thing and the bad thing about being a rookie is you really don't know what you don't know. And so in my naive rookiness, I just started reaching out to all the big networks, asking for meetings, and then going there and pitching them on my vision. I remember my first meetings when they're like, yeah, we would love to see what you got. Do you have a pitch deck? And my response was, I'll email that to you. Could you explain to me what you would like to see in said pitch deck, and I will get it to you by tomorrow. And then they'd be like, yeah, no worries. You get that to us. Do you have a sizzle reel to go with that you could show us? Could you explain to me what said sizzle reel is, what it might look like, and I will get that to you as soon as possible. So this was back in January, and I was going all around LA. I was meeting with Netflix and Disney Plus and HBO Max and Amazon and Sony and just anyone and everyone who'd take a meeting with me. I was hustling the town as much as possible. So every network I met with, they all wanted to see a sizzle reel. So I go home to Hawaii and I create a 2-minute edit of our family footage showing in the best way I can, like, this is who we are, what we represent, this is what we are about. And an animator who had been giving me advice and kind of mentoring me through this process, his name's Brian, he saw my 2-minute edit and he's like, when is your next meeting with Disney Plus? I was telling him this on like a Thursday, and my next meeting I think was on Monday or Tuesday. He's like, give me the weekend, let me see what I can do with this. Brian is so incredibly talented and worked so hard. So he like infused my sizzle with just some animation cartoon magic. Check it out.
This is the true story of the Bucket List family. An ordinary family that made the life-changing decision to sell everything and leave their home for an extraordinary adventure around the world. With no final destination in mind, they stepped outside their comfort zones and into the great unknown. The universe rewarded their brave choice with life-altering experiences, new friends and new places, cultural experiences that opened their hearts and minds, and magical wildlife encounters like something from a fairy tale. But this was no vacation. This family journey was also met with trials, obstacles, and heartbreak. Challenges that required them to believe in one another, grow stronger as a family, and together, be brave. But this is only the beginning. As this epic tale continues, it's up to the young family working together as travel journalists to share true stories from across the globe that will break down borders, conserve our fragile planet, and bring unifying inspiration to our world in a time when we need it most. The Bucket List family is a message to the world that no matter your background, race, politics, or beliefs, your family is your world, and you decide if it's filled with love or hate, closed prejudice or open kindness, fear and comfort, or brave adventure.
Showing that sizzle at each of the big meetings with the big networks, that was my favorite part, because to see these executives connect with our story on an emotional level, they got it. They immediately understood. And although like I was still trying to explain my vision of what we wanted to create, at least they understood our core. Like, this is what we're about. This is who we are and where we come from. That made all the difference. One of the big networks, they got us the very next night. I remember we were in Panama, and they sent us a contract to buy the bucket list cartoon the very next night.
What just happened, Gary?
Just got an email.
What does it say? Read it to me.
All right. That we would love to buy the bucket list cartoon and develop it with you guys. It's such a heartwarming show idea, and as you know, you guys have a lot of fans in this building. We see the series potential so clearly and would love to be your partners on this. I know you had other meetings and that you may have other suitors, but we would consider ourselves so lucky to get to work with you guys and bring this show to life together. The network said, you need to decide by Friday. You're either going to sign this deal or not. We made our decision. Friday came and we called the network and we let them know, thank you for everything, but we're going to build this independently. We expressed our gratitude for their excitement on our project, and we hope to work with them in the future perhaps, but for the early on stages of this project, of this cartoon, I think it's the right thing for our family, it's the right thing for this story and this world that we want to create. I think it's important for us to develop it independently. It was a big, scary decision. I was terrified for obvious reasons. Here's the big network wanting to pour like $10 million into the production of our cartoon. And here I am saying, I think we as a rookie who's never done this before, and as a young family, and we're gonna go build a team, and as a small team, we're going to try to do this on our own. It's terrifying on all fronts. But at the same time, as soon as I made the decision, like I knew inside, this is the right path, this is the right decision. And I woke up so excited today, ready to go about this. Just because we've chosen not to work with the big networks at this time doesn't mean we don't have big dreams and visions and goals for this project. If anything, that's added motivation for me to show what a small independent team can do. I plan to work closely with investors and give this project the expertise, the finances, and the most important of all, the talented team necessary to make this something truly special. It's gonna take a lot of work and a lot of time. The first season, the first episodes, it's gonna take time, but this is my favorite part of choosing to do this independently, is we get to include you and involve you along the way, every step along the way of this creation process. And it is by no accident that we are starting this today, Saturday, August 15th. Today happens to be the 5-year mark from when our family initially left home for an adventure all the way around the world. And so many of you were with us from the very beginning of our family journey. And that just means everything to us. And so now to get to include you and build this cartoon together with you, let's do this together. All right, so the last thing I'm gonna share with you, you wanna see something crazy? My mom sent this to me. It's a picture of me in the third grade, along with my goals and dreams at that age, what I wanted to be when I grow up. And how crazy, I didn't even know I had put this. Honestly, I can't even remember that stage. And putting there that I wanted to be the voice of a cartoon. Crazy world, right? All right, well, there you have it. That was our decision. This is either going to crash and burn and I'm going to regret this decision, or this is going to be something very big and very special. But even the biggest of things start in small places. In this case, it's going to be our garage. And I think we're about ready for the grand opening, so let's go. Oh, we're looking good.
It's business. What are you doing, Callie?
I'm business.
Hello?
Hello?
So it's an investor. You're an investor? Hi, Larry. Are you in or yeah?
Okay.
I like to hear that.
Hello?
Who is it?
It's an investor.
It's an investor?
Love it. Thanks, Christy. Welcome to the family.